Hi, my name is Martin Moss. I'm a market engineer based in Silicon Valley. So what I'm going to be showing you today is some LED reference design for the automotive domain. So LEDs have been used increasingly in automotive for issues associated with tail lights, forward facing lights, and rear lights. And they're starting to replace the incandescent bulb. So the reference design that we have chosen uses three components: a DC-DC converter, an LED PWM dimmer, and an operational amplifier. So traditional designs would connect the dimmer directly to the battery. So in this case, we've used a DC-DC converter because this can help with issues associated with thermals, solution size, and in some cases, reliability. So the product we chose was the LM53601. And the reason why we chose this was because it's very small, so it can help with issues associated with solution size. It is very high efficient, so it can help with thermal issues. It has very low noise, so it can help in terms of illumination. And also, it comes in a very compact overall solution. So the design that we've chosen here is designed specifically for the engineer in mind. We cover issues associated with how do we make the cost low enough that he can use the products? Also, how can we make it small enough that it can fit inside an LED display? And also, we've looked at issues associated with thermals and also EMI. We've done specific tests on the EMI for this reference design. So let me show you a couple of these examples from this demo here. So what we have is, in terms of equipment, we have an oscilloscope, a power supply, a PWM modulator, and the reference design down here. So the voltage on the power supply is at 6.5 volts. And on the output of these DC converter, you can see just around about 6.3, 6.4 volts. So first of all, you can see that this device is supporting very, very deep dropout, and we have very crisp illumination from the reference design. So what I'm going to do is increase the voltage here upwards. And what you should note is that the display is even, crisp, and no illumination distortion associated with it. So what I'm going to do now is show you a second example of this reference design in application. So I've changed the setup. The first thing I've done is moved the PWM controller down to just one channel, as can be seen here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the PWM generator up and down. And what you should be able to see is an even illumination of the LEDs down here. So as I increase the generator in terms of its duty cycle, what you can see is the LEDs getting more illuminated. And then as I decrease, the illumination will go down, but it's linear, crisp, and no distortion. So I've changed the setup again. And what I have here is an EMI demonstration of the DC-DC converter. So inside the box, we have two reference designs, which can be found on ti.com. The one down here has spread spectrum, and the one up here does not have spread spectrum. So this box has on either side of the channel a listens, which then go to a Pico scope analyzer and then read out on this laptop over here. So this box has been set up specifically designed for CISPRA 25 class 5 applications and to test EMI. So what you can see on the laptop over here is the two channels. The red channel represents without spread spectrum, and the blue channel represents with spread spectrum. And what you can see is the harmonics and the subharmonics, when you use spread spectrum, are then declined. So what I've been able to do today is show you superior EMI performance and also smooth operation of the LED reference design for automotive customers. For more information, go to ti.com or visit the website on the screen. Thank you very much for watching.